As usual, and I'm speaking on some things. All right, we're checking out that NF Loss featuring Hopsin. Let's get into it.
So excited for this. Oh my gosh, it's like a movie.
Look. Self-aware.
Wait.
Go ahead.
Okay, so already the vibe. What do you think?
I mean, we got the balloons, you know what I mean? So I feel like I'm in the know already. Right? We got the balloons.
Right? But okay, so he was in the desert in the search, or like kind of like in
it
the...
It wasn't the desert. There's plenty of grass and stuff. Okay. It was like a field.
In a field. Now he's in like the like snow fields. It's like in the Arctic or something.
I mean, it's called Lost. Yeah. And he looks like he's surviving. You got the fire lit. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. True.
My guy might be lost, and maybe he finds Hopsin, or Hopsin finds him, so lost, and now he's found. I don't know, maybe they're both lost, okay. And like they find each other, and they're lost together.
Soul searching.
Maybe.
Something like that.
But, okay, on this video, we are going to have to be kind of pause heavy, because last time there was a new release from this mixtape. It got blocked, we had to try and upload it 5 times, so we're going to have to pause
it
a lot.
Yeah, it was a lot.
Look, self-awareness, pride's a coat, and yes, I like to wear it. Buttoned up, don't like to let no air in with a pair of gloves that I hope doesn't perish. I discover though when I get holes in them and I let joy in, I'm in higher spirits. My mistakes are like a screaming parrot, just repeating lyrics. I can barely bear it when I'm lost. Road is narrow, I'm looking down it like a gun's barrel. Aren't we all searching?
Okay.
Ooh.
Hold up.
Ooh, I like the flow.
Me
too. It's different.
He said something like, my mistakes are like screaming parrots. Just repeating lyrics, I could barely bear it. Something to that effect.
Oh.
Is he talking about the effect of writing his feelings on a page, right?
Oh my goodness.
And then he has to constantly repeat it and perform it, you know, concerts and things like that. So like his mistakes are like screaming parrots.
Hoo-hoo.
Like it never stops because he has to keep reliving it. You know what I mean?
Fascinating.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's what he's getting at.
I love that he's just like reflecting how he feels, as he's going through this, because it's like it's one thing for us to like watch it and like critique it and like observe it and love it. It's another thing to like he's like living this. Like
right.
He's actually probably lost. Like he's actually probably like.
To a certain degree.
That's so interesting.
And I'm lost. Road is narrow. I'm looking down it like a gun's barrel. Aren't we all searching for the serum that could help us breathe and leave our state of peril? All of us have made defensive scarecrows that we scatter around our fields and treat like heroes when they scare away the things that we should cherish. Cause we're too embarrassed to admit the fears that we're lost. Yeah, but what does it matter? I get too combative inside of me's a personal canvas. The paint can be flat and get messy when I start to get rattled. The heart of a savage and quiet when I lurk in the shadow. Something on that up. I don't want to be over.
Okay, this is fast right here.
Ooh.
This is fast. Okay,
ooh.
I gotta try and keep up. This
ooh,
song, all I'm of us have defensive scarecrows that we put in the field.
Yeah.
It's like a protective mechanism.
Yeah. Yeah, at the beginning he was talking about ego. Like wearing ego. Oh.
Yeah, okay, so now I definitely feel like with this one right here, I mean, Cloud still had the stuff in it too, but this one with the balloons and everything, this is definitely part of the journey.
Definitely, right?
Definitely, because it has a symbolism. You know what I mean? It has a symbolism from stuff in the journey. Like, I see what people say in the comments, the journey never ends.
Oh, exciting.
So we have a lot more to go on the journey. This mixtape is coming out.
Right.
I thought we were almost done.
Glad to get messy when I start to get rattled. The heart of a savage and quiet when I lurk in the shadow. Something on that up. I don't want to be over dramatic, but look at the data. It's obvious that humans are fragile. We tend to get mad at the ones that call us out, but the fact is we need someone that'll be honest when we fly the handle. I admit I throw a fit when I begin to win.
Okay, we tend to get mad at the people who call us out. He said, the fact, look at the data. Humans are fragile.
Okay.
We tend to get mad at the people who call us out, but we need that. I mean, that's facts. But, I mean, sometimes calling someone out could be uncalled for. It depends what. Because a lot of it is just like...
Right.
It's criticism versus critiques
right.
and stuff like that. It's just some people just mean and hating.
Right.
But I get what he's saying. I agree 100%. You do
like,
need people who can help keep your ego in check.
Right. Because it's like with self-awareness. It's like, how do you know what is you and what is them? And what is you being insecure and, like, you know what I mean?
Right.
Even with, like, love and codependency. I was thinking about this morning. Love and codependency and stuff. It's like, how do you say you love someone when actually, like, your ego needs them to reassure you that you're okay? But then at the same time, it's like, what if they're at, like, we're just on time in the journey. So I'm like, what if they're, like, saying, oh, I need more time? Then it's like, how do you know that you're giving them time because you love them and not because you need them? You know what I mean?
Right.
mad at the ones that call us out, but the fact is we need someone that'll be honest when we fly that handle. I admit I throw a fit when I begin to unravel. Keep my wits been off the grip and now I'm back in the saddle. My intent is not to rant, I like the own what I value. I can take you on the fence and maybe pick up the paddle. I like the world against the current, that's the way that I travel. Opposite of what the greatest got, the brain of a rebel. Take initiative, I'm diligent on every level. I never can settle, I like to keep my foot in the pedal. Yeah, I love the pack arenas and all, but what I really wanna do is learn to handle my thoughts and put the reins on them, show them I'm the one that's the boss, and pull them back when they get out of hand and breaking their jaws. I'm taking the flaws and told me.
Okay, it's hard to pause this because you get so into it.
The flow is so cold in this. It's different.
He said, I love to pack arenas and all, but what I really want to do is handle my thoughts. As usual, NF speaking on some things.
I wonder how the whole pandemic did him. Like, with not being able to tour.
It may have been helpful.
Right?
At least he had to keep repeating the lyrics.
I guess we'll find out through the course of the mixing.
He kept screaming his mistakes at him. You know what I mean? At least he had to do that for a year.
Right.
But he was still making music, but it's new music now.
Right. I guess on the mixtape, we'll learn what happened through the pandemic.
Right. Maybe he was lost during the pandemic.
Ooh, or maybe, like, he realized he was lost, and then he found something during the pandemic. Like, you know?
We need to look at the list of the mixtape songs, see if there's any song, like, this, the opposite of lost.
And put the reins on them, show them I'm the one that's the boss, and pull them back when they get out of hand and breaking their jaws. I'm taking the flaws and told me I can never revolve, and pull a bane on them, ask them, oh, you think you're in charge? You ought to know better, ain't no way around it, applaud the traits that I want. They say I can't afford what it costs, but I
okay, balloons.
Is that gonna be Hopsin up there? Those balloons? That's why I paused it. I saw those more balloons up there.
Oh, I was wondering.
And that was a lot of balloons.
And you know what's funny?
What?
We just did Kumbaya Hopsin, but apparently he went to Thailand soul searching.
Right.
This song's called Lost. They're both finding each other in the middle of nowhere. Oh!
Match made in heaven.
What a collaboration.
Okay, we're about to get to the Hopsin verse. You see the balloons. You know it's got to be Hopsin up there with the balloons.
I'm so excited.
You ought to know better. Ain't no way around it. Applaud the traits that I want. They say I can't afford what it costs, but I manifested this. Failing's how you grow and learn your lessons, kids. Take the worst and try to make the best of it. Cause when you fail, just know that it's a test in it. You can learn to pick yourself back up again and train your brain to not be such a pessimist. It's okay to make mistakes, just don't forget that there's a high road, but I skip the exit when I'm lost. Yeah.
Okay, that part was tough. When he was talking to the kids or something to that effect.
Right.
And he was like, failures, there's lessons in them. Right. This and that.
And you can train your mind not to be a pessimist.
Right. Ooh, that's my favorite part of the whole song so far. Yeah. I love that message right there.
It reminds me of The Search when he's like, it'll only take a minute, okay? And I'm like, powerful place.
Just like that.
I love how he puts that message in there. Like,
right. It's such a powerful message. Like, that message really resonates.
I feel like in the beginning of his music, well, I don't know about moments, like way back, we haven't listened to that yet, but in Mansion and stuff, I didn't feel as many like inserts of like that message. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like it was definitely like his emotions and how he's feeling, what he's going through, but like the message has come in to play from The Search forward.
Right, so it's like the tide is turning.
It's nice to see, because I mean, I can only imagine him having a kid and just like overcoming him, like, you know, his past and his demons and stuff.
Right.
When I'm lost, when I'm lost.
Wow, these burdens are heavy, and I'm hoping it don't bury me. I used to be joyful and skip so merrily, but now I'm too cautious and tiptoe carefully. My mind left, and it's nowhere to be found. Am I a big old parody? Cause it's no fair to me. And now I'm at the point where I'm spending a grand a week on hypnotherapy. Look, I'm trying to watch.
Oh, hypnotherapy. Interesting.
Okay. Hopsin came in hard.
I mean, there's so much I could say about that.
He used to skip around merrily, and now he tiptoes carefully.
Yeah.
That was the part that stuck with me from that little segment.
I'd be wondering if he's just a big old parody.
Right?
Like, low-key, all those things are relatable. Spending a grand a week on hypnotherapy. It's like, you're thinking about, like, maybe this will work.
But when you're young, you definitely skip around merrily.
Yeah.
And it's partially because you have less responsibilities and things like that. Yeah. But you don't have to lose that, like, youthful exuberance about life as you get older.
Right.
It's like, I definitely went from skipping around, so to speak, and it wasn't really skipping, to tiptoeing. You know what I mean? But I feel like last year during the pandemic, we're just trapped in the house with each other. It's like, we found a way to be happy somehow. It's like,
yeah.
It was actually one of the happiest years of my life. And it was also one of the brokest. Yeah, you know what I mean? But it was just like, responsibilities were still there. Money was tight and all that. But I guess just spending more time together, just chilling.
Right.
Right here on the couch, watching a lot of Netflix and YouTube.
Literally, guys, Love is Blind. On the same couch right here, watching Love is Blind.
Just right here on the couch, just kicking it, you know?
Yep.
Watching a whole lot of YouTube, a whole lot of Netflix, just talking a whole lot.
Yeah.
We were basically reacting to videos when I recorded it. Just pausing it. Did you see that? You know what I mean?
Right.
I don't know. I feel like it brought back some of that youthful energy.
Right.
Like that skipping merrily energy, so to speak.
Cause it's no fair to me. And now I'm at the point where I'm spending a grand a week on hypnotherapy. Look, I'm trying to wash away my sins. I got a group of loved ones that ain't my friends. And if I ever take a nail, then they might grit. And they all want to see me stay in the cage I'm in. So when it come to anybody, there's no trust for no one. Man, so what? My whole plan's to go nuts. My shoulders ready for most drugs. I'm go judge anybody trying to enter my circle with no love. Hold, my sanity's gone.
Okay.
Oh.
I'm sorry, I wanted to pause it after 5 seconds, but I let it ride a little bit. So then, when I do that, though, I do forget.
I feel like they put a lot into this song. Like, they both came with it.
Right, but he said he has a bunch of loved ones and no friends, and they want to see him in the cage he's in.
Yeah.
Which is Andre Cage, you know, you got NF in the cage reference, you know what I mean?
Ooh.
But his loved ones want to see him in his cage.
Yep.
You know what I mean? In the cage, I guess they mentally project onto him how people should be.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I thought that was interesting. Loved ones with no friends, because like we've had similar experience with loved ones. Probably you guys probably have too. Like it could be well meaning. You know what I mean? But it's like, bro, like just don't try to like size me up and confine me into like the way you believe people should be. It's like,
oh, literally.
We're all different. Yeah. We have different experiences. We go through different things.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I can't live in that cage you want me to live in.
Yeah. I got a lot of loved ones who don't even talk to me because I don't live in the cage. Like they literally. It's like we're not even friends on Facebook. Actually, like they deleted me.
Right. It's like they'll delete you over petty stuff too. Won't even be like the three big things like race, politics, and religion.
No.
Won't be any of that stuff.
My shoulder's ready for most drugs. I'm gon' judge anybody trying to enter my circle with no love. Hold, my sanity's gone. I'd rather be torn from this planet they planted me on. Your stats a reward. I'm actually bored with having this sore heart. It's torn apart from a family that I don't have anymore. Now hold up. I was living so oblivious with millions. It really was a pity, huh? A pity. It's kind of funny what a penny does mixed in with a mini buzz. I feel stuck. Life slapped me by the neck with a plate against it. Cause I was
Ooh, I feel like they can relate to each other.
Right.
Like, it's funny what a penny does.
Right, I was living so oblivious with millions.
Right.
You know what I mean? In that part.
Yep.
But it's like that same thing, like money doesn't buy happiness.
Yeah.
And that is facts. So it's like I was just saying, we're as broke as we've ever been.
Right.
Had that 3-figure bank account. A lot of 2020. Right. But it's like that was actually the happiest like we have ever been.
Right.
It was like low key. The best year, I'd say mutually, the best year of our lives.
Right. Yeah. Strangely.
And so now it's like, okay, can we get our money back up and keep that level of happiness?
Right.
You know what I mean? Right. Coming at life from a different perspective, valuing different things after going through 2020. It's like, can we keep that perspective, still skip around merrily, and get the bag back up?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right. Right. Man. Yeah, I feel like they can relate a lot to each other because I feel like they're both hitting on, like, family, being a big kind of, like, sore spot.
Right.
And being lost. They both got their balloons. I love it.
With a mini buzz. I feel stuck. Life got me by the neck with a blade against it. Because I was running late for the train and missed it. The only thing I feel is pain and vengeance. So I'm going to act out like a raging misfit. And every verse I lay goes stay sadistic. You want to hate me? Good, great, terrific. You'll never see the day when my anger's dismissed. You better go and change your wish list. Because I... manifested this. Do not treat me like some adolescent kid.
Okay. Ooh. Gotta be heavy on the pause. Just have to, or it's gonna get blocked. You know,
but
YouTube
I mean,
does.
We have a lot to say about this anyway. So.
What you got?
What you got?
I was saying, Hopsin says there's never gonna be time where his anger's dismissed.
Yeah.
Hopsin, he does. He has the anger thing.
Yep. He does.
The only reason I'm laughing about it is not that having you know a lot of anger is funny, but like the way he delivers some of his angry verses. Just historically, from listening to Hopsin for years.
It's so, like...
It's hilarious the way he delivers it. And he's so unapologetic with it. But just the way he delivers things. Just like in Kumbaya, we just listened to it. It's like my enemies I might mop the floor with. Like, that cracked me up. Like, the way he delivers his anger is the funniest thing ever to me. Like,
Dude, it's hilarious. I liked how... So, like, a little ways back, he said, don't trust no one.
Right.
And it's like, basically, it seems like... Both of them have this, like, similar journey of, like, building up a wall and whatever. But it's, like, some of that wall that they built up, they like it. Like, it protects them in a good, like...
Well, that's what people were saying in the comments. in that one song, we were trying to figure out who they was. Mm-hmm. And they're talking about fear. Part of fear's role is to protect you. At least that's what it serves the purpose of that. So it's like, yeah, when you're dealing with things, you do have the protective aspect of it, and it's comfortable. You're scared of the unknown.
Right.
So I feel like it's kind of that aspect, too.
Yeah, because it's like some of these, like, relatives, some of these things are, like, definitively, like, yeah, it's probably, like, you know, bad for them.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like, I don't know. It's very interesting. It's like they both have that, like, wall, but it serves a purpose.
Right. Mm. And it's built from, like, past experience. Like, right. He's like family members trying to keep him in the cage. But then he also said, like, something about judging anyone who comes in a circle without love. So it's like, you can't come in the circle, but you better come with love.
Right. Right. And I do feel like at this level, like, they probably had so much experience, so many people that were in and out of their lives that they probably have, like, a very, like, very good filter.
Right.
So. Wishlist, because manifested this. Do not treat me like some adolescent kid. I am praying to the Lord with the book of James, hoping he go wear my testament. This dark cloud, that's my residence. Demons knocking, I don't have to let them in. I done made mistakes day to day, you probably can't relate. I just ain't the same when I'm lost. Yeah. When I'm lost. So that part, we didn't even go over it, but he said, do not treat me like some adolescent kid. I manifested this. I feel like that is such a point.
Yeah.
Because when you do have, like, relatives who, like, view you a certain way, want you in a certain box, they love to tell you, like, they love to be, like, you know, basically, like, put you back into your little box. Like,
right.
Well, when you get older, or, like, well, you'll see one day, or, like, you're different because of this, or you've always thought for yourself, but most people aren't, like, you know what I mean? They love to, like, belittle your perspective. And, like, put themselves on a pedestal.
And then he also must get that, like, oh, you got lucky. Because he's like, don't treat me like a kid. I manifested this. Like, I earned this. I worked hard for this. Mm-hmm. So I'm guessing that line's coming from people telling him, oh, you got lucky, this, this, and that. You know what I mean? But NF also mentioned he manifested something in this song, too. If I'm not mistaken. But, yeah. So they both must kind of get that. Yeah. When I'm lost. What? You don't see any people, so they must be buried under the snow like Hopsin was.
Oh?
You know, I see balloons, I don't see people.
Yeah, interesting. What people do you think those were?
Us.
So you think it was like everyone's lost?
Yes.
What do you think the significance of being buried was?
I guess being found. I don't know.
Buried under their problems?
Yeah, Hopsin did say something like the burden was heavy or something like that. Mm. But the balloons also represent the problems. So I don't know. I don't know.
Okay, I got another thing for you.
Okay.
On the cinematography.
Okay.
How insane do you think that environment was to shoot that video in?
Yeah, that was probably
crazy. I mean, can you imagine, like, filters on the mics and, like, just, like, the sound and, like, the wind and, like, the elements plus the, like, altitude? Because they were at the beginning, they were kind of like going down that hill that Hopsin was buried on.
Yeah, it was probably
and it was insane. Cold.
Maybe even multi-day shoot, right? You know? Who knows?
Like, did they bring heaters, but there's no electric outlet?
No, it was cold.
But, I mean, I guess you could power it with a vehicle. Did they drive
vehicles? You got propane heaters and stuff, but
true.
Maybe even taking a helicopter. Who knows?
That was like, that reminded me of that movie, The Revenant, with Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh, yeah.
Very tough conditions.
So the last scene reminded me of The Search. Remember, like, the last scene was a bunch of people in white walking around. Did they have balloons? I don't remember. But it was, like, a bunch of people at the end in white. And then this, you have probably a bunch of people under the snow with their balloons.
Mm. I was like, oh, is this all features from the album? But then...
No, it's only one more feature.
Yeah. Their schedules are probably so crazy that, like, they might have, like, he might, like, Hopsin might have brought in his feature and everything. And who knows how many times they, like, coherently had the song before they shot it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, their lives had to be crazy. I could see how they would feel lost. You know what I mean? Like, my goodness, there's so many people projecting
right. The
version of them they want them to be onto them. Right. There's a lot of them. But you get what I'm saying.
They is them.
Oh, my. All right. It's time to wrap it up. It's time to wrap it up. All right. Thank you for kicking it on the couch with us. We appreciate you. Especially if you made it all the way, especially if you made it all the way to the end. Thanks for supporting our channel. Let us know down below anything we missed, any references that tie back to the journey, all that kind of, you know, NF cinematic universe kind of stuff. Let us know what we missed or just give us some feedback on the video. Appreciate you. That's a wrap.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.